Oh my goodness. So I'm into now the second this other one, the poplar tree. And oh, this is a fabulous funny. This one it goes because it's tonight. Okay, it says tonight. I am but firewood. And shed your flame. Let me see how this can work on this. Tonight, I am but firewood, and should your flame set me on fire, let it consume me into ashes, for only then will I begin to live. So that's such a taunt, isn't it? So yeah, she's taunting you. She wants to just be firewood, and just turn into ashes, because that would be a true life. That would be a real beginning in live, you know. But for some reason, for her, firewood going into ashes is there. Just have been consumed by it. Yeah. Ashes are a true beginning, actually, when you think about it. Ashes are a true beginning. Yeah. It's an interesting one. Because at the beginning, I'm like, whoa, she's being consumed by the flame, you know, by the fire. And that's the living part. But in reality, it's the justified end here of the ashes. It's an odd, strange. Right. Yeah, I have this other one here. What is this other one? Oh my gosh. Oh, there's a whole bunch in here. A whole bunch. Sparrows and beaches and things. All right. Yeah, I haven't actually read it at all. Shame on me. It says, "The toots goes to my mother. A sample of my poor work," she says. She thinks it's her poor work. It was from her early years, and each one is dated at, 1950 or something. So yeah, it's from her very early years. It's typical sentiment of a woman, the downgrade status here. Demote yourself, you know. It's not great. Pretty awful. But so what I'm into here is there was one I was reading. Oh my God, a thing dies. A thing dies. Now this is actually I'm loving her titles. Her titles are amazing. She's a title, a title holder, a title carrier, a title, or one of those, the title taunter type. You know, I love titles also. I've always loved titles, but yeah, she's a title taunter type. She knows how to bring a title to the piece and just start to wake you up, going, "Well, I definitely want to read that. My God, a thing dies. That's incredible. I've never even heard that in the title." So there. Okay, so a thing dies, and when held between two palms. For fear that it will fly away, and love, that which is most enduring when it spreads its wings, withers when it is possessed. Caged like a bird, its arms tangled like vines that cannot climb, or roots enclosed in stone. What the heck? Yeah, this is one that I have to study. That's not something I can just read out. My gosh, a thing dies when held between two palms for fear that it will fly away. So it's something smashed, smushed, and love, you know. And that which is most enduring when it spreads its wings. So it's greatest when it actually gets a little bit of freedom in there. It's almost like when you catch a butterfly in your hands and it still twitters, flutters. When it's possessed, caged like a bird, yeah. Its arms tangled, like vines that cannot climb. Yeah, it's feeling trapped in there. Or roots enclosed in stone. Yow, roots enclosed in stone. That's a trap. Yeah, so this is something that is alive, yet almost a suffocation state that she's discussing. Yeah. The thing is not dying great, that's for sure. My God. She's a funny one. Okay, and so this one was called The Poplar Tree. Collected poems from 1918 to 1986. So she really was funny, collecting her poems throughout her life. And all of a sudden there they are in the book. She was so small. She was shorter than me, you know, I think like 2 inches or something, 3 inches shorter. Tiny, tiny woman. Oh my gosh. And oddly, she doesn't, like, you know, whiplash you with Christianity sentiment, even though she was a, you know, major church worker type. She doesn't really even bring it in. It's kind of good that she doesn't, you know, put God into every sentence or, you know, every poem. Well, there's God again, you know. So it's kind of refreshing, you know, for a woman of her time frame to not, you know, put God there again and again. Yeah. Oh, no one knows. No one knows. Here's another funny title. No one knows why a sparrow falls. The whippoorwill won't tell. What lifts a wing past heavenward? What drowns a soul in hell? Oh my gosh. Well, here, as I was saying, you know, she doesn't bring in God or anything, but we've got heaven, we've got hell. So that's how she does it. She'll sneak it in, but not too serious. Okay, so we're having the whippoorwill is here, it won't tell, it lifts its wing past heavenward, that's way the heck up there, and drowns a soul into hell. Alright. So I asked a seagull, I asked a crow, they did not answer, but somehow I know. Trade winds batter, lost ships at sea. And gently below, a small canoe, I ask the wind, why this is so? It did not answer, but somehow I know. So that's just kind of an odd little journey into rhyme all of a sudden. I know that tricked you, huh? Somehow I know again. I like that cadence style. That was pretty. You know, this is a beauty. Look at that. So yeah, so you get the like the style of it. And look at that, the short. She got the short wedding gown there in the photo. The short wedding gown. Now that is something also, because I got married in the short wedding gown twice. And so because I got married in the short wedding gown, I wonder what that is, because I didn't know she got married in the short wedding gown. Isn't that odd? That's an odd strange. Yeah. Very odd. Funny. Because I there's probably something with it, you know, you get married in a short wedding gown and it doesn't last long or something, I don't know. Hurry up, let this be over. You know, maybe that's all, you know. Weddings are boring. All right, so yeah, what was that all about? Oh, and then there's the peach tree. Okay, well, oh my goodness. The peach tree, still sleepy from its winter nap. Oh, don't you love that moment, you know, with the fruit tree, how it is napping? And before it's actually turned into the bud, and it's turned into that ripe moment, and it has that color, you know, it starts to bring that color. The very beginning moment when it starts to press out into the color, it is absolutely an astounding state, isn't it? It's great, because it's just like a renewal. Like, we know it's going to happen, you know. We just have to have patience and wait. Just have to have patience. It's just the most buoyant time ever, because that means with summer, with spring, you will have summer, and you will also have a new winter that you can eat. It is phenomenal. It's the greatest experience ever, that moment. So here we are. Still sleepy, though, this one is, the peach tree, from its winter nap. The pregnant tree stood proud, while hordes of bees from all around enveiled it in a shroud of amber lace. And then the face of each new bud was washed with April rain, so that the sun could touch the heart where mysteries had lain. Oh my gosh, that is so beautiful. That is so beautiful, isn't it? I know, there are secrets, Elden Trees, aren't there? Alright, folks. Well, anyway, that's the Poplar Tree one. So, yeah. What a sweet, sweet grandma I had.